All right, what's going on, everybody? Thank you for tuning in to episode 2 of my little vlogging channel. And I'd like to first off say I absolutely suck. So last episode, I ended off saying something along the lines of like, I'll catch you guys at the next meal. There was plenty of next meals, but I did not get my camera out because I've learned that like as I was starting to do this, like it's really odd to remember like if you're doing something for the purpose of content or you want content for whatever you're doing. It is so weird to have to remember to take your camera and record it or take a picture to like to get that content that you can put in your videos. But anyways, I finished with about these macros. I'll put it in one of the corners of the screen. And that's about a normal day for me. Yesterday, my girlfriend and I actually went out to Chick-fil-A because she had to go pick up her laptop and it was just close. And that kind of threw a wrench in all my macros because fast food really just absolutely ruins your macro balance. But on a typical day, I'll have about 205 grams of protein, a million quadrillion carbs, and like no fat because it's just easiest for me. It is about, let's see here, 12:12 right now. I'm a little early from when I'm supposed to train with Patrick, but my classes got out at about 10:25. I took a Spanish exam, which I did not know I had until about 5:15 minutes prior. It was a conversation exam. It went all right. But I figured since we were wrapped up with classes, my girlfriend's at her classes, I'd go ahead and get training done. So I will catch you guys inside. Just mixed up my pre-workout drink, put the Gatorade in the Powerade bottle. Still trying to decide if that's sacrilegious in some way, but we got our pre-workout mixed up. Let's train. You're a puppy.
Hi.
Yeah.
You're a puppy. I know. She's so cute. I love her.
And it comes about in nowhere like an evil surprise. And it hovers over you to tell you millions of lies. You don't relate to that? Must have been as crazy as love. The chicken is the mind is a powerful place. And we can affect you in a powerful way. It's pretty cool, right? Yeah, but it's not what I'm saying. Just hang with me. Just only take a moment.
Absolutely not.
Think about it for a second. If I said what call you, baby, that's just my way of letting the lady know she's working on me. Rapping about the way I feel. Oh, yeah. I just want to make a couple mil. Leave it to the fam and the will. Oh, yeah. I just want to sign a record deal. Maybe buy a house up in the hills. Okay. Oh, yeah. Might not be the best of my feel, but I guarantee that you're dead real. When I grow, I just want to pay my bills.
Yep. Easy.
Alrighty, so we finished up with bench press or with a deadlift, and we set a nice little sumo PR 492 by 3. And and we're about to start Larson Press, so stay tuned. What's going on, everybody? Let me get you adjusted here. We just got out of the gym. The workout was absolutely phenomenal. Another phenomenal workout this week. It's been the theme of this whole block. I pulled 492 for three, which was kind of a misload. I meant to load 485 just for the ease of plates, and I knew that was like a manageable weight for me, and I just forgot to account for some plates that I put on, and it just cluttered brains from being hyped with lifting, ended up screwing up my whole top set, which admittedly, as you saw, it did move, and it was in a complete overshot of what it should have been. That being said, really, really excited with how it moved, really excited that it moved at all, because, I mean, for four days of doing sumo in total, I've messed around with sumo earlier, but not enough to make it non-negligible. For it to move like that with only 4 days of sumo training at that weight, that's super, super cool. It doesn't look like I'm going to be stronger on sumo, but nonetheless has been a fun spice to my training, and maybe, who knows, next block it'll start taking off as whatever Steve incorporates into my programming, and hopefully maybe it'll take off and we'll see something different. But outside of that, my calories have been good, my macros have been good, and I've been keeping consistent with the diet, which has in turn completely transformed my training. I'm still at 210 to 211, depending on the time of day and how much I've eaten before I weigh in. But generally speaking, I'm about 210, and I'm feeling absolutely amazing. So now that we're out of the gym, we're going to go back home, going to go pick up a check for my girlfriend, grab some dinner, and then knock some homework out. And this time I actually will. I said catch you guys in the next meal last one. This time I actually will catch you guys in the next meal. So. Alright, so a little time skip from the last little clip I did is now, as you can see, 7:16 p.m. And my girlfriend and I right now are working on, we were working on homework. Say hi.
Hi.
Anyways, for dinner we went and got pizza and I got a shrimp entree. So I'll put the macros somewhere on the screen, or the macros of the meal and the macros of the day. And we will keep keeping track of those until the very end of the day. But other than that, I'm going to work on some homework, probably finishing up my diet, finishing up filming today's video. And then I'm probably going to start editing it and hopefully upload it tonight. So, yeah, catch you guys in the next meal. Alright, so this is not actually the next meal, but I have been suckered into a form of date night by my girlfriend. And it is skincare. So, my skin looks all shiny. Dang. So, I'm gonna be laying here while my lovely girlfriend puts on this face mask, and you guys get to see a little bit of a time lapse of me being perpetually uncomfortable. So, we'll start that now. Enjoy the show.
It's so cold.
Okay. How do I feel?
Almost uncomfortable.
So, what we have is Peyton has a charcoal mask, and this is not sponsored, but it's by Yes2, which is my favorite mask line, and it's a peel-off mask, so you get to watch this after it dries get peeled off. And then on his lips, we did a scrub, and after that, I wiped it off, and we put on the little lip mask, and he also has these little ice cold cucumbers, which you just put in the freezer for 15 minutes, but we might have left them in for a little bit longer than that.
15 fucking hours.
Shut up. It wasn't that long. But, yeah. And after his dries, he's going to do it to me.
Time lapse. So, here I am post-skincare routine, and I feel like I'm... I won't lie, I complained about it at the very start, but I did end up liking it. My skin feels really soft. But we ended up doing a... What was it, babe?
It's called a quartz roller. You're supposed to rub it on your face, where our tension is. And it helps your blood flow and your skin to absorb either the face mask or like lotion put on your face.
Yeah, that fun stuff. So we did that, and it was a lot of fun. And I feel like my skin does look a little bit better. It could just be a placebo effect. But anyways, we are cooking, or I've just cooked up my final meal. So I will roll the next clip, which I recorded before this one, because I forgot. All right, so final little clip of the day. We made my final, or one of my final meals of the day. And it is, we have a bowl of just some plain old microwave rice with tuna, and I blew it through a packet of the Chick-fil-A sweet and spicy sriracha. We get 20 pizza rolls, a cup of tea, and then we will have another bowl of minute rice and tuna before I go to bed. Now, I know this is like a really weird food combination, but trust me when I say this is actually the secret to weight gain. If you just throw away your preconceived conventions about food combinations, you will immediately gain weight because you can eat anything together. You are literally unstoppable. But anyways, I am going to end the video here. So thank you guys for watching, and I hope you enjoyed. I'll catch you on the next one.